Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 110 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 186 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 187. Question 187. You have an Azure subscription that contains the resources shown in the following table. We have one load balancer, two virtual machines VM1 and VM2. Next part is, load balancer 1 is configured as shown in the following table. Load balancer 1 has the backend pool where virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 are added. Load balancer front end has the front end IP configuration where one public IP is configured. It has one health probe, HP probe 1. And these are the details, and it has one rule 1, which is the load balancing rule to receive the traffic on port 80. You plan to create new inbound net rules that meet the following requirements. The requirement 1 is the provide remote desktop access to virtual machine 1 from internet by using port of 3389. Provide remote desktop access to virtual machine 2 from internet by using port 3389 of that virtual machine. What should you create on load balancer 1 before you can create a new inbound net rules? This question is available over the internet with various doubts and conflicting answers. Therefore, I have decided that we will be practically checking it, that what is the requirement to have an inbound net rule over the Azure portal. So let's go to Azure portal. We are in Azure portal. We'll go to resource group RG1. We have virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 in our resource group. We'll go to create. We'll create load balancer. Click load balancer. Click create. We'll provide the name LB1 as mentioned in the question. Keep it standard. We'll keep it public load balancer, regional. Next we'll add front end IP configuration. Name of front end IP configuration is provided. We will keep the IP version IPv4, IP type IP address. We'll choose the existing IP address and add. Next, backend pools. Add a backend pool. Name of backend pool provided in question is BE pool 1. We'll select existing virtual network. Backend pool configuration, we'll keep on NIC. Add IP configuration, we'll select virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2. Add, save. Next, we'll go for inbound rules. A load balancing rule distributes incoming traffic that is sent to selected IP address and port combination across a group of backend pool instances. The load balancing rule uses a health probe to determine which backend instances are eligible to receive traffic. We'll add a load balancing rule as mentioned in the question. Name of the rule is given rule 1. We'll select front-end IP address. We will select the backend pool which we have created, BE pool 1. We'll select the port 80. This is for internet traffic and backend port would remain 80. We'll create health probe. Name of the health probe is given HProbe 1. Protocol TCP. Port 80, interval 5 seconds, press save and we'll hit save. load balancing rule 1 is configured. Now the requirement is that we need to create inbound net rule. An inbound net rule forwards incoming traffic sent to selected IP address and port combination to a specific virtual machine. We are looking for an inbound net rule for RDP connections for each virtual machine. Hit add an inbound net rule, RDP rule VM1. This will be the rule for virtual machine 1 for remote desktop connection. Azure virtual machine, we'll target virtual machine 1. We will select here network IP configuration. And we'll choose here front-end IP address. Front-end port, we can choose any front-end port to target the virtual machine 1 for having RDP connection. So we'll select 3400. We'll keep service tag custom and backend port would be 3389. We'll hit add. So one inbound net rule is configured for virtual machine 1 and it will receive the traffic on 3400 and send the traffic to RDP port of virtual machine 1. Next, we will add another inbound net rule for virtual machine 2. RDP rule VM2. We'll select the virtual machine 2. IP configuration same, front end IP is load balancer front end IP. We'll try keeping the same port like the previous one, 3400. Here we will receive an error. We cannot have two net rules targeting different virtual machine on same IP and port. We'll change the port to 3500 and we'll target on virtual machine 2 3389 port. Now we should be able to add it. Therefore, the front end port would remain different, but the virtual machine port would be the same for RDP. If you have noticed from the answer set, there is no backend option available to configure inbound net rule. There is no health probe option available to configure the inbound net rule, and there is no requirement of load balancing rule to configure the inbound net rule. Therefore, only and only front end IP address is required to configure an inbound net rule. Let's go back to question. Therefore, to configure the inbound net rule on load balancer 1, we just need a front end IP address. Option A is the correct answer. Load balancer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel. Press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.